Hey everybody, how are you? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. How are things going? Just make sure I got my volume actually up. There we go. If you don't know how I came across your Facebook feed, it's because somebody might have shared my Facebook Live. This one might be shared a lot because it's controversial. I don't do these things to be controversial. I do these things just to help educate the general public for dog owners. All of my Facebook Lives are geared towards dog owners. The reason is there's so much misinformation out there, and I'm going to talk about something called punishment, which a lot of people don't like to talk about. If you want to find out more about me, you can go to Solid Canine Training. There's a link right up there. You go to my Facebook page. We've got over 50,000 posts, 5,000 videos. We're balanced trainers, so we believe in yes and no. We do a ton of praise, but we absolutely punish dogs for unacceptable behavior, which again, a lot of people don't like to talk about. Good morning, Lise, how are you? If you want to share this, you can also share down here. So I've got a dog here named Odie. This is what the inspiration for me to make this is. There's Odie right there. And Odie's been with us for about 4 to 5 days. And Odie's got about 12 or 13 bites on you know, to the dog. And it made me think, and I'm looking at Odie, who's doing really, 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 really well right now, and we've always known this, that you're going to come across a lot of information online, a lot of trainers, a lot of different, you know, supposedly science studies, which actually a lot of these studies are actually false. Yes, I'm actually going to make the statement saying that a lot of studies that are done by behaviorists and vets are actually false. Nobody actually is really studying punishment actually out there. The theory is that if you correct or punish a dog for aggression, the dog is just going to be suppressing the aggressive tendencies, and one of these days the dog's going to have it's like a ticking time bomb and it's just going to explode. I just want you to know that that's actually an outright blatant lie. It's never been proven, and it's never been studied before. It's a theory that somebody just has that, well, of course, the dog will just explode one day. The issue is that most bad behaviors in society that people do not do are suppressed. Just think about this logically. Why do you not steal? Because you're suppressing the urge to steal. Why are you not physically abusive to somebody? You're suppressing the urge to be physically abusive to somebody. We can talk about rehab in a bunch of different ways, and that's when it's rehab. So do we want to wipe the concept out of suppression? So should the dog just know not to bite? Of course the dog should know not to bite, but it's also a dog. All dogs bite. They are canines. They are animals. They're technically wild dogs that we've domesticated. They have teeth. Their mouths are designed to bite. A dog biting is just a way of communicating with you saying, what you just did, I don't like, and I'm going to move you away. Dogs bite for two reasons, because they think they have to, and because they want to. So, hey Tom, I miss you too, buddy. What you do is you take those two things away. But no matter how well you train your dog in obedience, no matter how well the dog's obedience is, no matter how many tricks that the dog knows, if it's a search and rescue dog, because we've worked with all these dogs. We work with agility dogs. We work with search and rescue dogs. We work with controlled biting dogs. We work with family dogs. We work with show dogs. No matter how well these dogs do in life, in their tasks, in their job, that does not mean they won't bite. That's a separate category. So everything they do, which is great, wonderful, good for them, massive amounts of praise, massive amounts of rewards, physical touch, all the wonderful stuff. But biting has to be punished. Punishment is not an abuse. And what people have to do is they have to stop having that conversation that it's abusive. That's not abusive. Punishment, all punishment is, it's a split second moment in time, 1 to 3 seconds, which is put on the dog that says, what you just did, I don't like. That's it. What kind of punishment? There's all kinds of different levels of punishment. Unfortunately, withholding praise, withholding a reward, which actually is punishment, is not enough to stop a biting dog. Now, if people start writing scientific stuff below, I'm going to delete it. The reason why I'm going to delete it is because that's a cop-out. that really is a cop-out. What you're doing is you're taking somebody's information that has not been validated, and you're just cutting it and pasting it and putting it out there without actually thinking rationally. I am sorry, but no matter how much you praise a dog, no matter how much positive reinforcement you give a dog, it will not stop it from biting. No matter how many times you do not give a dog a reward, which is punishment, if you want to talk about quadrants, the withholding of a reward is punishment, the dog will not stop biting. It cannot be done. It cannot be done. When this dog right here, okay, so that dog right there, good boy, good boy, good job, praise, right? So praise. No matter how much I praise, I don't have any food on me right now. If I give that dog lots of food, all right, which we do food training here as well. If I give the dog lots of food, good boy, give food, physical touch, all the wonderful stuff that the dog does to keep doing the command. If I said the word break and then I threw the dog a toy, toy being praised as well. So all of those things that are positive is going to reinforce this dog staying in command. And guess what? We do that. We do that. Every one of my trainers and myself reinforces wanted commands with food, physical touch, verbal praise, and toys. That's what we do here. If I'm walking by this dog and it bites my leg, what do I do? Answer that question. If you disagree with punishment, answer that question. What would you do? Don't answer it with a scientific cut and paste thing. What would you do? What would you do if you walked by this dog and it bit you on the leg? Think about this. Think about this. If I took the dog and say I put it in a crate, it would never stop biting. If I walked away, it would never stop biting. If I told it no, and then give it something to do, something else to do, it would not stop biting. The only way to get a dog from the act of biting is to punish the dog in the moment the unwanted behavior happened. Let's please start thinking like rational human beings. And stop thinking that by training a dog what you want will fix what you don't want when it comes to aggression. Think rationally. Don't look it up in a textbook because it's not going to be there. Right? It's not going to be there. Pinning him on the ground? No. It won't work. It won't work. I would never pin a biting dog on the ground. You'll get bit in the face. Never pin a dog on the... I would never do that. I would never get that close to the dog's face. Because then you're going to get your dog to bite you in the face. I actually want to be hands-off. How do you punish? Okay. We punish a lot of different ways. The dog has a remote collar on. We would use a high-level stim on the remote collar. The dog has a leash and a prong collar on. We would use a very firm leash pop. But I would prefer to use electronics because it's neutral. Because it is neutral from me. In other words, it's saying the act that you just did is very uncomfortable to you. The act that you just did is very uncomfortable to you. Now, what I want people to do is I don't want people to just focus on that 1 second high-level correction, because I know that's what you're going to want to like focus on. I want you to listen to everything I just said. And I'm not talking to you like you're an idiot, and I apologize if it's coming across that way. We use food, physical touch, verbal praise, toys to reinforce wanted behaviors. Okay? We do all of that. But if this dog bites me, or bites one of my dogs, or bites another human being, there will be a 1 to 3 second very uncomfortable consequence for the act of biting. I will not yell, I will not scream, I will not be mad at the dog, but I will, okay, I will give the dog very clear information that what they just did was wrong. Think, process, it makes sense. I don't care how well this dog, who actually does have over a dozen bites, does that. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You can't stop an unwanted, dangerous behavior by ignoring it, by praising what you want, by redirecting. It cannot be done. It cannot be done. So I just wanted to talk about this because there's a lot of dog owners. Remember, my all of my life with Facebook and all my social media is designed for dog owners. If someone else's dog runs up and bites me, there'll be a serious consequence for that dog. I'll use my feet. Absolutely. I'm not going to let, like, hello. You know, a dog could kill a human being. Like, dogs kill humans. I'm just now tuning in. You're going to have to, watch the replay on that. Watch the replay on that, Allison. So watch the replay on that. And I talk about this all the time. So remember, folks that use remote collars, folks that are balanced trainers, don't just focus on the punishment. So, don't see the behavior that is error and counter condition to punish the behavior without searching the source. Well, you don't really need to search the source at all. You have to punish the behavior, it won't stop. Now, if this dog was in pain, say this dog had an ear infection and I was massaging its ears and it bit me. That's a different story. Say the dog had an impacted tooth and I went to pet it and it bit me. But guess what? That rarely happens. That's like 1% of the bites out there. I specialize in aggression. So keep that in mind. I specialize in aggression rehab. All the dogs that are biting us are not because of physical pain. This is what the source is. The dog is biting us because it wants to, or it thinks it has to. That's why. And if you want to counter condition, if you have huge discomfort to a dog for biting, it will rethink its biting. Again, think about what I just said. 95% of what we do is praise. 95%. Most of our day is based on reward-based training. 5% is based on a punisher. It's so important that people understand the conversation. A lot of people, what they try to do is they try to be like, redirect the conversation. What's the source? A lot of times it doesn't make a difference what the source is. All right? It doesn't make a difference what the source is. If I was walking by this dog and it bit my leg, I don't need to know what the source is. The dog bit my leg. It gets corrected. So next time when I walk by it, it won't bite me. This is what corrections are. People, what they're doing is they're thinking too much. And how do I know it works? Because we specialize this and we've done it a lot. So a lot of the conversation sometimes goes, you shouldn't punish the dog until you know why it's biting. I agree, but if it's not physically in pain, it shouldn't be biting us. And even dogs that are physically in pain usually don't bite either. But most dogs are not physically in pain. Most dogs are entitled, pushy, snotty, and get away with it because nobody ever told them not to. And you're going to get a lot of people out there. Danny, how are you? You're going to get a lot of people out there that have got all kinds of different theories, but have never been put into application. James, I already talked about what I would do. So we would use a remote collar or a prong collar, and we would give the dog a high correction, a split-second punishment. It's not abusive. People have got to start saying that it's abusive. It's not abusive. I welcome anybody into our training center to get bit by a dog, okay? To get bit by a dog and show me what you would do. Take a bite from a dog and show me what you would do. Because it's important that people understand that, like, this is life and death for the dog. And it's also life and death for possibly a human. Does that make sense? Because no is knocked it off no matter what the behavior. Yeah, pretty much, yeah, you have to say no. It's okay to say no to your dog. This whole conversation out there that people are like, that's 30-year-old training. No, it's not 30-year-old training. You know? If a dog bit me, I would go as high as I could. Don't worry about the number, as high as you can. Okay, let's, like, guys, can we scale this? The dog just bit us. Are we not listening? Now, I'm not yelling at you guys. I'm just like, I understand the conversation that's going on out there. People will say, then you're not addressing the real core issue. Yeah, you are. That's a bunch of bullshit. Of course, you know, of course you're addressing the core issue. Okay? It's biting you. So, I agree with you for e-collar correction, but in real life at a client's house, you do the best you can with what you have as a tool on the dog on arrival. Well, the dog, Sophie, first of all, the dog shouldn't be near you on arrival. You know, if you are going into a client's house that has a biting dog, the dog should be on a leash, put away. The dog should have no access to you whatsoever. What would you do if after or during the correction the dog escalates? Your correction was not high enough. Your correction was not high enough. Now, people again are going to say that's 30 or 40 year old, you know, dominant theory training. No, it's not. Like, just to give everybody like a heads up, no, it's not. This is what is the situation, what is happening. Biting dogs are going to shelters and being killed. That's the reality of it. A biting dog goes to an animal shelter and is killed. Like, are we scaling our thing? So you can come up with this great, wonderful theory, but putting it into practice is not working. Again, 5% of our training with a dog is a correction. 95% is not. Being in the UK, you guys have check chains in the UK. So the best way to prevent biting, remember, it's not necessarily the tool, it's the way the dog looks at the consequence. Are you believable? All right. As a new dog trainer, Alex, do not work with aggression. As a new dog trainer, don't work with aggression. That's my advice. All right? Don't work with aggression. Stay away from aggression as a new dog trainer. I want you to work with 200 dogs before you touch aggression. So you understand how dogs think, how they learn, what their drive is. That's what I want you to do. And I'm saying this, and I know that these Facebook Lives, people love to start throwing theory on me. Oh my God, my storage is almost full. Shoot, I might get kicked off of this. All right, so I'm gonna have to end this really soon. Why can't my storage be full? All right, so people have got to understand that, again, just to sum it all up, we use food, physical touch, verbal praise and toys to reinforce wanted behaviors. 95% of our day is how we spend that. 5% of the day, it would be based on a correction. All right? Scale it. All right, play biting. Oh, just stick your finger in its mouth and push down on its tongue. So, you gotta be super quick. So the dog's biting you, boom, boom. It's super quick. All right? Remember, that's it. This is what we do every day. It's not a theory we have. It's something we actually practice, and it works. And it works. And someone will say, well, all you're doing is suppressing it. It might come back again. Okay? Join a gym. Lose weight. Eat healthy. Quit the gym. Eat bad. You got fat again. Yep. You're right. If you don't keep up with your structure, if you don't keep up with your consequence, you go back to the old behavior no matter what you do. In other words, guess what? If I don't praise and reinforce and reward what I want, that also goes away. It's a two-way street, guys. If I don't reward my dog for what I want, that also gets worse. It's called dog training. It's called learning. Don't just focus on that 5% and be attacking. Listen to the whole conversation. Listen to the whole conversation. So when people put posts saying, oh, so you just correct dogs, you didn't listen to the conversation. You didn't listen to my conversation. All right? Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training, madly in love with you. You're all special. I put this stuff out there because dog owners are struggling. 5 million dogs are being killed in our shelters every year. People are living with aggressive dogs. And I want you to know the way to stop aggression is to punish the act of aggression. The act of aggression has to be punished. It will never go away without it. What is the punishment? Something the dog believes. That's all that matters. Are you believable? Are you believable? Think about that. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training, Facebook Live. Take care.